أعزائي المشاهدين، أهلا وسهلا بكم من جديد مع برنامجكم الأسبوعي برنامج إماراتي. كما عودناكم في كل أسبوع نستضيف لكم خيرة من دولة الإمارات قصة نجاح أتتنا إلى الدولة منذ عام 2016. مستر سوميش، good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
We are so lucky to be here with you in your company. Our team said to you, welcome in our program.
It's my privilege.
And we would like to know about yourself. Who's Sumish when he comes to this country at the first time and what he's doing at this moment?
Okay, I came here in 2016. I was the commercial director or the business head for Levi Strauss & Company for whole of Middle East and North Africa. I was managing 26 countries. And now I'm an entrepreneur here since 2018. I run this, my company, Cosmo Smith General Trading. We are more known by our brand called Clapit, which is all about hanging solutions or drill-free hanging solutions. We have more than seven products now. Yeah, we have seven products already there in the market.
From Indonesia to UAE, let's talk about the first day for you in this country, how it was.
It was amazing. The first time I came here, I think in January 2016, for I started managing from Indonesia itself. And the whole city was so vibrant. It looked like there was just so much of energy. And of course, the first thing after you land at the airport was, how do I see, where do I see Burj Khalifa? And the moment you move out of the airport, you are able to see Burj Khalifa, and the entire trip, I was continuously watching that. It was just so inspirational.
So we stay here around 2 years. After that, you start to take the decision that you want to start your own business.
Yes.
Your son, school story, give you the idea or the light to start your own business. What was the story?
Yeah, so my son, he was in grade 10. It was a school project, and he was supposed to develop a product which can solve somebody's customer's problems. So he came out with this idea, looking at a lamp which was broken. Broken in the sense that one of the screws of that lamp had come out, so it was hanging upside down. And he was wondering about, why is that not fixed? And when in the discussion I said, look, for this one, there will be two or three people who have to drive all the way around 25 kilometers to this place to fix up one screw and then go back 25 kilometers. It's expensive. It is challenging for the whole environment also. So somebody took a decision not to repair it at all, but it doesn't look nice and it is dangerous in case the lamps are hanging like that. So he came out with this idea that it should be something simple. Something simply, you just pick it up from the table and you should be able to hang. It should be sort of something like magnetic, and we discussed that for at length. Then he came out with something like, okay, it should be something magnetic, which has to be put on the wall. I said, okay, just go ahead and research about that. So when he started doing the research, he found that this was a very common problem. And a lot of people are tenants over here. They are living in apartments every year, 2 years, they shift their apartments. If they drill holes, they are not even allowed to drill holes in the apartments. If they drill holes, they have to pay penalties. And also, those are permanent damages to the walls. These are not that landlords love to put up penalties. It's a permanent damage to the walls. It's a waste of resource. So, and there were hardly any solutions for this. So he developed one solution with which he was able to hang my home theater system on the wall. And I was surprised, this big speakers, and they were hanging on the wall and we were playing it at full volume, vibrations, etc. happened, but the speakers didn't fall. And it went on for a month. I was surprised, I was astonished, the kind of a product that they had developed. And this was all done by sourcing samples from US, some magnet samples, some strips. And we used to prepare those strips because the strip has to be of a certain thickness, and that thickness iron was not available, steel was not available. So we used to use the adhesive to make it thicker and to put it over there, and then it just did wonders. I still have got some of these products hanging on the original ones, the round strips that we used to use there. Just a memento for me. And then, look, this was always in my dream to have my own business. I was there in India before, and then I moved to Indonesia. When I was in Indonesia, the idea came in that I should have a business. But frankly, I found it to be a little difficult to start business there. It was a linguistic challenges, it was cultural challenges. In Dubai, when I started business for Levi's, I found it was so simple. All the contracts were bilingual. So that means I could read the entire contract myself. You go to any of the departments, everybody was talking to me in English, sometimes even in Hindi. So very welcoming, the whole experience. I said, look, starting a business over here is easy. And I've got a great idea. Nobody's doing anything about it. It looks like this is an ideal opportunity for me to leave that whole job, jump into this business.
2018, starting the business. 2019, Corona came.
Yes.
Corona, when it came, everyone sit in the home. So everyone starts looking what I need in my home to fix or to prepare, because this is our research, it's happening. So what was Corona affected your company?
Yes, that is interesting. So we launched our first product in September 2019. And as we were expanding our distribution, within 6 months, Corona hit. So you're all stuck at home. The positive side of that was that people were staying at home. So they had those empty walls that we had noticed earlier, and they wanted to design those walls. Thanks to Amazon, the e-commerce started picking up pretty well. And we had listed our products on e-commerce, and then we found that people had, they bought a lot of clappets from us using e-commerce and some of the retail stores as well. The other thing that happened during Corona was, while we were sitting at home and there was little that we could do, so we started working on our second project, which was about mobile phone holders. And we wanted a universal mobile phone holder which can be used in cars, at home, in your kitchen, in your bathroom, on your study table. You should be able to use it anywhere. It should be small enough. And what we developed was this bigger product. Now, hanging mobile phones for us, hanging a product for us, was as simple as this. Now, hanging a mobile phone was also, it'll occupy only 1 inch of space. As simple as that. I drove it through the dunes to test it, and it was working extremely well. So it's by the time the markets opened, that was in, I think, in October 2020.
Yes.
We had our second product also in the market, which is Selma.
We can say it's something sustainable.
It is.
When we talk about sustainable city, we need to mention COP28. So now everyone going for green, so we don't know what the future is keep for us now. So this is one of the products that you talk about, and also there is other products we can talk about it. What the other products?
Okay. So talking about this product, we're using steel, 100% sustainable. Its usage is long-term. Everything that you see hanging over here has been hanging here for since January 2019. It's been 4 years. That means without drilling a hole, they're able to hang everything over here, and all our products are reusable. The magnet, we have kept it to be detachable completely so that you can safely secure it. When you're moving your home, you should be able to reuse it. The steel, you can remove that. It's the only thing that is not reusable in this is going to be the adhesive, which is the smallest of the things. Mm-hmm. So everything in our products is reusable.
Normal magnetic, it's the capacity of it, how much?
So the gauss power of a normal magnet that we use on refrigerators, etc., is around 20 to 30 gauss power.
But 300 we are talking
This
about.
One is 300 horsepower. This is the strongest magnet of its size. We, as I mentioned, that we, this idea when it developed, it was about, okay, should we have the magnet permanently stuck on the steel? I said, no, we don't want that. We don't want the magnets to be wasted. Okay? We don't want walls to be carrying empty magnets everywhere. So in case somebody is doing a gallery wall of 50 photo frames, we don't want that after they remove those photo frames, the 50 magnets are sticking over there. A lot of solutions that you find using magnetism, even in cars also, the magnets are wasted after the usage. You just throw it away. And that's not the way that you should leave the magnets. These are rare earth metals that we use. These should be reusable, and if they are not being used, they should be heated so that they are demagnetized completely.
We cannot manufacture the magnet. It's some stone, it's be in the earth, right?
Yes, there is a material called neodymium, which is added together with some of the other materials to develop the magnet. And neodymium is a rare earth metal. I mean, it's not that supply is limited anymore.
Yes.
There is sufficient quantity available, but it is a specialized material.
Always in this business, when we talk about the future, there is many plans. What is your main plan, or what? Where is the target of your company now?
So our vision is to eliminate nails and screws from every home and office. We want a 6-year-old to an 80-year-old person should be able to design their walls all by themselves without any external labor, without any external any additional habit, without using those drill machines which can actually damage you so badly, not only your walls but you yourself also.
This magnetic will not affect the frequency for example, Etosalat do the signal is coming for us, or it's not affect at all?
It doesn't affect at all. There was a perception when we used to have the televisions which use CRT tubes, cathode ray tubes. Those instruments were affected by magnets, because in cathode ray tube, what happens is that there is a stream of electrons that moves through a vacuum tube.
Yes.
And electrons are negatively charged. When you put up a magnet, they tend to divert. And that is what used to cause damage to the cathode ray tube.
Right.
Ever since we got rid of the cathode ray tubes and we moved to the LEDs, LCDs and LEDs, magnets are absolutely safe. In fact, most of your mobile phones, they have got magnets inside. All your speakers, they have the same neodymium magnet.
Aye.
The heavy bass that you hear nowadays in your AirPods, it's because of neodymium magnets being used inside.
And you have fair enough stock in your stores here for any inquiry coming for you?
Yes, our products we sell in different stores, all the major stores, Al Futtaim, Ace Hardware, we are there in Landmark stores, Home Center.
Under which brand?
Clapit.
Clapit.
Yeah.
So now Clapit, how many products they have in the market?
We have a total of 7 products now.
Mm-hmm.
We have magnetic hanging strips, we have cell mount, then we have 2 super tapes. Super tape is a super strong tape. Imagine this tape has a holding capacity of 150 pounds, 68 kgs, one roll. So far, we have the amount of tape that we have sold, we estimate that close to around 11,000 tons of products are hanging on our tapes.
And when we talk about the construction side, they care to use so much of tape, so you have solution for the construction?
We are more consumer driven, so we want to give these tools to everybody so that they do everything by themselves. You don't require any labor.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but the construction industry has also started taking a lot of our products, but from the retail stores, from in the retail manner only.
And waterproof also product you have?
Yes, so we have a paper tape that is 100% waterproof.
So in our business, always when we talk about any business, many people, they will come and they have maybe the same idea, or they challenge you. How you can make yourself different between you and your challengers in this market?
You see, how we are different is because we we are consumer focused. We understand what the customer wants. We literally live in the houses of the customers and we ask them continuously, what do they want? Everybody is using masking tape. Everybody was using masking tape for paintings. When we went and we spoke to the laborers, said, okay, tell me, is this masking tape good? They used to say that, sir, we have lots of problems. When we peel it off on the edges, the paint has already gone inside.
Right.
And therefore, we have to do additional labor to clean it up. Some of them, they said that when we heat it, especially in automobiles, you spray the paint and then it goes through heat treatment. And when you remove the tape, you have the adhesive over there. Then you have to buy an adhesive remover and somebody has to clean that adhesive. So you have to do all of that. If you can develop a solution that can get rid of that. Then we studied the paints. The paints are coming in different viscosities now. There are the paints which have got a lot of water content now. So what is the best solution for that? What in case we can have a bit of a coating on the paper itself so that we can make it 100% waterproof. And that's what we got. This is 100% waterproof. I can literally put water on this. And there is not a drop of water that will ever go inside. Not a drop of water will go on the other side. So.
And it's safe for electronics, right?
Sorry?
Safe for electronics also.
Yes, but it is still a masking tape. So it is not a 100% permanent solution. It'll last, so all your sanitary work, all your paint work, etc. It'll last for a couple of days, 7 days, 8 days. That's a typically the test that we do. You can tear it. And imagine this tearability, and this is 100% waterproof.
It's work under candles or what you cover it?
Sorry?
The material of cover this tape, what is it?
So there is a special treatment that we have to do on the paper itself, mm-hmm. which makes it waterproof.
So, who support you in your life, Mr. Somesh?
My biggest support is my family. My son is still with me and he has always been there with me. Great education in UAE. Now he's studying in Canada. But he does come back over here for 4 months of vacation, and during those 4 months, he does help me with a lot of things.
How is the wife supporting the businessman?
So my wife, there are two parts of my wife. One is being a wife. She has been such a big emotional support to me. Of course, when you start a business and you have in 6 months Corona hitting you, you're mentally thwarted. What do I do next? So she has been a great emotional support. She's also taken up a challenge that she manages our social media now. I was finding it a little difficult to have somebody with the same passion as myself. Knowledge is easily acquirable. You can acquire knowledge easily, but passion is something that should come from within.
Right.
So. And marketing is one of our main portfolios. We have to communicate well. So she took over the challenge. She said, okay, I'll handle all the social media for you. I'll communicate on your behalf. So
UAE have many newcomers coming for her every day or every month. So many investors, many employees, some people come here as a tourism only. What the first advice you can give it for these people?
If you ever want to do a business in any of the countries, UAE is the place for that. It's there right in the center of the world. So geographically, it is an amazing place. But that's something that has come naturally to UAE. The big thing that UAE has developed is a whole culture. The culture that helps businesses to expand. There is a certain amount of optimism and positivity that almost comes every morning. from the leaders. You just pick up the newspaper and you then forget all the challenges that you had yesterday, because there are just so many good stories that are there. There is some good message that you'll always find every day. UAE is the place to do business.
Yes, UAE gave us many things, and you said before the interview that UAE always, during Corona, the leader was saying things that make us more like the future, and we believe them. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed mentioned for us, La tshilun ham. It means don't care, so we will solve it, and they solve it. The first country which opened the doors is UAE. And it's the vision of His Highness Sheikh Zayed, Al-Salam Zayed, they make it number one. What you will say for the leaders and government for all this opportunity? That's what.
There are two things. One is that you see the wall behind me?
Yes.
This is on the wood. This I call as my inspiration wall. Whenever I am in stress, I look at this wall. And one of the pictures that you see on the left, this one.
Yeah.
If you have nothing, you can create anything and everything. You see the pictures there? This from old Dubai, where there was nothing, and we created everything. Big inspiration. When you have nothing, you can create everything. Another important thing that I want to say over here is thanks to the UAE's visionary leadership for shaping a future where businesses flourish and dreams become reality in Dubai. It was my dream to start a business when I was there in Indonesia, when I was there in India, Indonesia. And that dream became a reality within 2 years of my coming to India. All my life, I was carrying this dream. In 2 years, that dream became a reality.
That's why they call it land of opportunity.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for spending your time with our team, and welcome again in our program. Thank you.
Thank you. في كل إمارة تروح تسلك عقل وروح في الرمود وجبال حاجة ترد